We start this morning with the same story we started with yesterday, and a new word that I had never used before because of his gender and his status and because of his formerly very prominent position in the media. Are some of us guilty of attaching himpathy to the misdeeds of Jeffrey Toobin? Salon Magazine refers to this as the mental gymnastics some people go through to try and explain away what Toobin did. In other words, if this kind of act was committed by just some anonymous Joe, no one would care if he was fired and disappeared from his work forever. I think there might be some sympathy among comedy writers too. While some might suggest it is too soon, you'd have to think if a politician or someone else outside of the LA and New York media elite bubble did what Toobin did, all the late night comics would be all over it. The only quip we could find, and we looked through all the shows, a minor jab from Jimmy Fallon.
Hey, this is interesting. I just read that, what is it? Incoming Zoom from Jeffrey Toobin. No, hang up, decline.
And you can see, it's kind of too soon. Meanwhile, over at The View, conversation started very, very serious, as you'll see here.
What does also merit an investigation is why would someone show this lack of impulse control? Is this somehow related to, is this addictive behavior? Is this related to the pandemic? Are we talking about, again, an addiction related to these unprecedented times? Right. I think that merits some investigation because this is extremely odd and
unusual.
Unusual behavior.
Yeah.
All right. I think this is why she's here. Sarah Haynes, just like most people, not a fancy lawyer, she's a mom. And if you can temporarily set aside the career collapse of Toobin, the outrageousness and foolishness of this specific act, in some point of view, it's pretty hilarious.
What do you make of this turn of events, Sarah? Because it's just, it seems so, such a strange thing to do when you know people, you've been working and talking to people. What's your take on this?
I'm sorry. I usually give women a lot of credit for multitasking, but this is a gear switch I could leave to only a man. This was during an election simulation, which is the most, I'm sorry, the most unsexy thing I've ever heard of. And I'm not going to be able to unsee this. I very much miss the days when Jennifer went to the bathroom and forgot to turn off her camera.
Yes.
I'm so sorry. I know there's a lot of seriousness to this topic. It's just really hard because I can't fathom a situation where this was the option A and B.
Oh, my gosh.
So, I mean, but
look at Sonny. Sonny's like,
Sonny knows him. Sonny has worked with him. They're colleagues. But you...
Sarah's got a very valid point there.
Exactly. As for Toobin's professional fate, he remains on leave from CNN. So far, no comment on where may not be his permanent status at the news network.